We got our guy.
Oh, this is a legend.
You're not kidding. You say legend. This guy fits the bill. The man is an entertainer. It's right there in his name. We're joined by Cedric the Entertainer. Good morning, sir.
Going on. Justin, what's happening, man?
Dude,
what's happening? How y'all doing?
No, we're doing great,
Cedric. We're doing great, Cedric. Hey, listen, listen. We're concerned. We're concerned, and you need to hear me out. You need to hear me out.
Okay.
Are you going on stage these days with a full security detail?
It's funny. I was going to ask him that. Have you spoken on that whole thing?
I'm just now starting to get back on stage. So I'm actually, you know, traveling right now. So I haven't actually had a chance to go up since all this mayhem has been going on. So, but, you know, I definitely wear an Iron Man suit when I go up here for now. You know, I just want to be on it.
Hey, Cedric the Entertainer, Go ahead.
Practicing my hip toss.
Doing some judo. Go ahead. Rush the stage. You're going to end up on your ass.
Yeah, it seems like Chappelle did maybe like a little sidestep. Chappelle did like a little ole. Like,
yeah. Yeah, you'd have taken out early 2000 Chappelle when he was like a buck 50. Now he's 220 pounds of pure muscle.
Yeah. I was glad. Yeah. I was like, the comics are getting a little bit better with their defense. Like each time, you know, an incident happens. So, you know, by the time, you know, it's going to be good. Like, you know, like Chris just took one straight across the chin, and that was it. Even no defense, didn't get out the way. And then Dave, like, all right, cool, and then the security jumped in. So the next time, it's going to be just a whole hip toss. That's when I'm throwing somebody smooth across the stage.
So, Cedric the Entertainer joining us. Have you come out and officially given your take on the – I know it's kind of dated at this point, but I would love to hear your take on the whole Will Smith-Chris Rock thing.
I didn't really have a take on it, man. I mean, I know both of those guys really well. Really sad to see it happen. That was the main thing. I didn't think it was really about the joke. I think it was definitely something going on, you know, something else where Will was just like in another place and anybody could have got slapped that night, and it was like, you know, it's like when you you get a whooping when you're a kid and it's because of something your siblings did.
Right.
And you're like, oh, what'd I do? And that's what that felt like. Like, huh? What'd I say?
Well, yeah, I didn't do nothing.
He's ready to slap somebody for something else.
Right. So I heard that you're in Dubai right now. Is that true?
Yeah, man, sitting over here chilling. I'm like in that tallest building right now, the Burj Khalifa.
Oh, I hear that's another world.
Yeah.
What are you doing there?
It is amazing. You know, my good friend Russell Peters is over here doing a show. So a couple weeks back, he was like, "I'm going to Dubai to do a show." I'm like, "Man, I got 2 days off. I'm coming." So that was it. So I just decided to come, and that was it.
So you've come a very long way from, around in the 80s, you worked as a State Farm insurance adjuster.
Yeah, man. I was the original Jake, man. I had the best with the red shirt.
Does that help you with your career now in any way?
You know, I don't get any kind of insurance deals, that's for sure. No, you know, I mean, the thing is, but I will assess every fender bender car accident. So I see my wife is like, okay, enough already. Like, you know, as soon as I see any kind of thing, I'm like, oh, they're liable.
That's going to cost them. Oh, yeah. Yeah, the guy behind him's at fault. I can tell. Yeah.
Yes.
That's a code 785B.
Oh, look at me. Look at the angle.
Look at the
skid marks on the street. You can tell.
He didn't even try and break. By the way, the sitcom, The Neighborhood, he directed an episode of it. CBS, Paramount. That's good. That's out now. Check it out. The Neighborhood alongside, Max Greenfield, Beth Bears, Cedric the Entertainer. Sean McKinney is freaking hilarious on that show.
And do you feel good having a venue now like this show where you can maybe tackle some of the issues that, they're still evident in this country. Maybe people choose not to say they are, but, you know, they still exist, right? You got a white neighbor and then you're Cedric and you kind of come out on the front yards and, you know, that you discuss all sorts of things.
Yeah, that's what's really great about the show. It's a natural kind of setup to talk about anything that's going on in, you know, a microcosm of anything that's going on in the real world. So from gas prices to, you know, what you deal with as a parent, you know, all of the, you know, the things, all the social injustice that was going on a couple of years ago with the George Floyd of it all. We covered any of those kind of things, yeah. you know, health, prostate exams, trying to get men to go and make sure they get checked out and get early exams, you know, any of these kind of things we can do naturally on the show. So we've been having a good time with that kind of stuff.
Yeah, and I can identify, Cedric, I've got a white neighbor, and they are so weird.
Yeah.
They had a barbecue where, speak so on this, weird. They put peas in the mac and cheese. Someone hands peas in the mac and cheese to you. What do you do?
Yeah, you literally have to bar them from the neighborhood at this point. You have to be like, look, guys, y'all can't come over here. Don't ever, let me see the recipe book that have put peas in mac and cheese.
How to make food less good. Sure
yeah, exactly. Well, nobody wants peas anyway. It's just the way, like, you trick kids into eating peas is by putting it in mac and cheese, I guess.
Yeah. Hey, Cedric the Entertainer, you're in Dubai. When you flew over there, did you fly in one of those, like, fancy little compartment-type things where you can sleep and stretch out and do all that?
Yeah. I did Emirates Air.
Yeah. Emirates.
You know, it's like a small... Yeah, it's like a little small one-bedroom apartment that you get. Like, it's kind of pretty cool. Like, you know... Yeah, it's like, you know, you got your own TV and an ottoman, and people can come visit you, and you can sit in your own little space. It was pretty dope.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it was worth it.
And I'd be remiss if I didn't get a chance to bring up one of my favorite comedians of all time that you know probably better than anybody was Bernie Mac, man. That you worked alongside the late, great Bernie Mac, you know, one of the kings of comedy. Dude, the Bernie Mac show was, to this day, was ahead of its time.
Oh my
it's
God.
So funny. You know, is there anything that we could do, like, moving forward, like a documentary about him? I feel like for some reason, people have Steve Harvey on The Family Feud. D.L. Hughley's out there filling stadiums. You're in Dubai right now, balling, but... I don't.
And Bernie would have been right there alongside.
Bernie would have been selling out Madison 100%. Square Garden. I don't want his memory to fade. It's like a project or something that you and the guys can do to introduce a new generation to how great he was.
Yeah, definitely. We actually Kevin Hart's producing a project that I'm slated to possibly direct. It's a very cool idea. They're doing like a documentary film animation kind of mixture thing. Should be really dope, man. And so we're just trying to get all of the details locked down. But awesome. We definitely, man, we love B-Mac, man, always. Even talking about doing a small kind of Kings of Comedy return possibly in 2023 where we would do like a, you know, a whole like honor to him with a set that we would edit of stuff that people have never seen that we would edit to make him have a set that you just kind of watch on the screen.
Yeah, you do the hologram stuff now.
Like a Tupac hologram.
Oh, yeah.
Like Dio.
Oh, man. I don't. You know, when somebody showed me a Bernie Mac hologram and the dude, all he was doing was like, let me tell you.
You got to watch The Neighborhood. It's available. Dude, get back safely from Dubai, and when you are here again selling out a stadium, okay, when you're at the Meyerhoff, when you're at the
Baltimore.
Come to Baltimore, let us know. Hippodrome, we would love to have you in, man.
All right, man, no doubt. We'll love that, man. Let's go, baby. Y'all watch The Neighborhood on Monday nights, man. Let's go.
Done and done. Fly safe. We'll talk to you soon, Cedric.